Hi, Uncle Dan.
Dan. Hi, thank you for being here. Hey, welcome to Chat TV. I gotta show you guys this food. So we gotta go up here. Look at what we have. Oh my goodness. This is our chicken jalapeno. And our homemade cookie. Oh, the jalapenos are grilled. Oh, they just look fantastic.
And once again, a shout out to the customer service. I told them I was not crazy about jalapenos, so they took them off my portion and they put them on the side, so Tim might enjoy them.
Oh, Tim will enjoy them. Now, I'm gonna get this over here.
The scent of the soup is driving me crazy.
I want to try that soup.
Okay, you find the spoon? Ready?
All right.
There's one spoon, but that's okay, we can share.
For sure. Okay, so we are doing our first restaurant review. We're live at the Vanilla Bean Bakery in Santa Monica. We're at the cross of 30th Street and Ocean Boulevard. The Vanilla Bean Bakery, they're brand new, just barely or 2 months old. Their sign's not even out yet, but they've got a full house in here, delicious foods, and I already showed you the desserts in the case. And we're gonna eat. So you guys, this is gonna be new. I hope you enjoy this. I don't know what it's gonna be like. Have you tried the soup yet?
Here I go. You take a bite and I'll take a bite at the same time. Ready?
All right.
One.
Sure. Which is my half. I gotta eat the right half, don't I? Maybe they're all on the side? I don't know.
Okay. Ready?
Uh-huh. Mmm.
Wow. Oh, This is creamy but not heavy.
There's pesto in this.
You don't like pesto?
I love it.
You love it? You gotta try a bite of that. And this is my half of the chicken?
Oh. I don't think there's any jalapenos in there. I think I gotta...
Are you gonna put them on?
I think I do.
Okay.
And we got the potato leek soup. Oh my God. This is so creamy.
This is amazing. This is... Oh.
Yeah, that sandwich. The pesto, right?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Again. Delicious, but not heavy.
Is it okay to eat on camera?
We're breaking all the rules today.
Oh my gosh, that is...
That's the thing with Ted TV.
I wish that spoon
was
bigger.
A little of this,
a little of that. I don't want it.
As long as it's legal, we'll be doing it.
That's right. Jalapenos are on the sandwich. Oh, so good.
I'm being a real rebel here. I'm dipping my soup. It's delicious. One of the things we like about this is it's really creamy without being too heavy. And that is a fine line to walk. Yes.
Yeah.
Plenty of sandwiches that I've had. It's traditionally a really heavy sandwich. And somehow they
figure
out how to make it.
These are fantastic. That's David, our server, Jack of all trades. You saw the interview with him already. Just checking on us because customer service is so keen here. You know, they highly... they value customer service, giving the best customer service.
Absolutely.
It shows.
It's as though they really want to make sure that you're not just having a good meal, but a good experience.
Right, right. And I doubt it's just because we got a camera and a microphone here. I think they go up to all their customers to make sure that they're having a pleasant experience. But if you're in doubt, you come here with a camera and a microphone because customer service is just impeccable.
Michael and I came in unknowingly right before they were about to close on Tuesday because
Anniversary,
and we wanted to try out a new place. He's big into trying new places. And it wasn't until we ordered that he said, okay, well, he even asked our permission. He goes, is it okay if I make it for you guys to go? Because we're about to close, but if you really need to eat it here, well, we'll just go ahead and stay open.
Who
would do that?
Not many. No. The talking stick does that. I will say that. The talking stick will not kick you out. They wait till you leave before they lock the door. But again, you know, it's another homegrown place, you know. It's not, I'm not at a Starbucks. No offense to Starbucks, but you know, when it's closed, it's closed.
Starbucks is a chain.
They're just different rules when you're at these mom and pop shops or homegrown shops or just locally owned businesses. It's a very different experience.
Now, when you own a place like this, it just, you're going to have a bigger investment than if you're district manager of 15 Starbucks. It's just, you can't pay the same kind of attention to details. Is that incredible? Dip your sandwich in that.
Good idea.
It's so amazing.
Oh my God.
Right?
Oh my God. No spinach.
David recommended Rel, didn't he?
This is fantastic. You guys, when you come to Santa Monica, You gotta come visit the Vanilla Bean Bakery.
Yes, you do.
This is just fantastic.
Your poor uncle is stuck eating hot dogs.
Oh, is he? Oh, no. My uncle is eating hot dogs. I have just misplaced you for 42 years. That's awesome. This is my Uncle Dan.
Hi, Uncle Dan.
It's so great. I think I met my Uncle Dan when I was, like, little. My dad drove me and my brother out to Ohio to meet the family. But I was, I don't know, 4 or 5 years old when we took that trip. I don't remember very much about it, except being in my dad's little sports car, which only had 2 seats and 3 of us. Long trip. And I remember some baklava, and I just love Greek pastries and all the yumminess. And I bet you I met Uncle Dan then. I don't remember it, but I get to re-meet Uncle Dan now.
Mm. Uncles are really good. My uncle by marriage, Dennis Stowe, even though he hasn't been a big part of my life since I was about 13,
uh-huh.
I had a really chaotic home life. My stepfather was, you know, as many New England men of that generation are, you smack first, you ask questions later, and my mother's an alcoholic. But Uncle Dennis, you know, they were visiting us one summer. I didn't like the way my mother was treating me. The guy barely knew me, and he was like, you know, if you keep treating her like, we'll take her with us when we go. We'll raise her as our own. Not related by blood. Just decided that he wasn't going to tolerate it. There are very few people like that. So there's a soft spot in my heart for uncles. All Damn. Uncles anyway. Are you an uncle? You are an uncle.
I am an uncle.
Yes, one of your nephews just graduated high school.
Yes, he did. Austin.
Yep. Austin. Yep. Shout out to Austin. I am a great aunt. My sister is now a grandmother.
I have a graduation card for Austin that is still sitting on my car dashboard, which I need to get in the mail. I am just terrible at putting things in the mail. That's why I don't have very good credit.
So that's why I wanted to send that. Ethan Zone, as we were talking about earlier, we bumped into him talking stick. He's interviewing for... Oh, sorry, I got
think
yours.
You got the jalapenos, girl.
And you know what? Not bad.
Good.
Not as bad as I thought they were going to be.
They're not spicy. I mean, you know, they're not like burningly hot spicy.
Ethan was in the middle of doing stuff, and I don't know if you heard me asking somebody if he'd be available to talk to him. But the first second he got, he looked up and he said, "Hi, I'm Ethan." And he's surrounded by his people. And I said, I know you're busy, but I just want to take this chance to say that my brother-in-law is from my last marriage. Love you. And he goes, "Great, what's your brother-in-law's name?" He signed the picture for me. He even said, "Do you want to take a picture of you and I together?" So someone took a picture of his camera.
Oh, you got it.
He suggested all this stuff. He was in the middle of working.
That's all. Yeah, yeah, they were working today.
But he took the time to notice and reach out to. And he's a wonderful, wonderful guy. He, as we were talking about before, he began the grassroots soccer, which helps. AIDS patients and HIV patients in Africa.
Mm.
You know, so this guy is, he's what my grandfather would have called a hot ticket, you know, cool guy.
Well, speaking of cool guys and hot tickets, the reason they were at the Talking Stick today working was pretty darn cool, because they had Jesse Billhauser, who is at 17 years old, a well-known surfer here in the Palisades, was in a tragic accident which left him a quadriplegic. He was told he'd never surf again, but he turned that around and started an organization called Life Rolls On, and he's like the national director. He's the director of the national outreach. He's a humanitarian, a motivational speaker. I was pulling up all kinds of stuff on the web about him. I didn't know him at all, but, you know, he walked in today. Film crew walked in today. All this stuff was happening. I just had TV doing my research and found out that tomorrow on Zuma Beach, at Zuma Beach, which is up near Malibu, we're going to have... We got... I'm missing Bud Light.
Being Greek is cool.
Being Greek is the only way to be. I love being Greek. Right on, Unc. Tomorrow up at Zuma Beach, 200-plus paralyzed surfers are going to hit the waves. And this TV crew is going up there to cover it because they're doing a feel-good story on Jesse Bowser. And I think Ted TV is going to end up at Zuma Beach tomorrow because we're going to help make that feel-good story get some legs and spread it out for them. And it was a fun day. I didn't expect to have a television crew inside the talking stick today. I knew I was going to be doing this.
But how inspiring, and that's apparently what the entire television show that Ethan Zone is hosting is about. People that have had a tragedy and have still persevered. There are some people whose spirits you just cannot crush.
We're going to have to stop that recording, I think. Which is good because we just finished that bite.
That was so good.
Oh my God, that's delicious.